Hello, this is Pastor Sandy McQueen from the Turin Missionary Baptist Church, and it's so good to have you on social media to join with us on our moment of inspirational message to encourage you, your family, in this coronavirus experience, that God get the glory in all that we do and all that we go through, for He is God all by Himself, and He's worthy of our praise. If you are watching on social media from wherever you are, you can say that you are indeed blessed, because the Lord has spared you and I to be alive to witness this wonderful day. Once again, the devil is constantly shooting arrows against the people of God in order to afflict us in one area of our lives or another. But thank God that there's total liberation through the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes, the power of the Holy Spirit has you and I. And without the aid of the Holy Spirit, we become as targets under a serious threat. Without the aid of the Holy Spirit, you and I become as sitting ducks under the ambush of evilness. And Satan, yes, he still comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. However, there is not an option of survival. There's not an option A, B, or C. The only option of survival is the Holy Spirit is our way of escape. And therefore, we must be aware and alert and also rejoicing, yes, even in times of depressions. What then are arrows? Let us look in Psalms 91, beginning at stanza 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, and in Him will I trust. Surely He have delivered thee from the snares of the fowler and from the noisome palaces. He shall cover thy face with His feathers, and under His wings shall thy trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. Final verse, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flieth by the day. And that's what I want to encourage you on today. I want to talk about the flying arrows of today. What then are arrows? Arrows are harmful weapons that have the capacity to cause a damage or a slow death on a living entity. These spiritual arrows are invisible attacks from the kingdom of darkness to specific or unspecified targets. However, the good news to us today is that God has not given us a spirit of fear. God has given us power over the enemy and all of his schemes and devices that are common in our world today. However, we need to know that Satan has all of God's people under his destruction scope, I like to call, because he has our homes in radar. He has our finances in his radar. He has our career and job opportunities in his radar. He even knows our addresses. He knows where you and I hang out. He knows our family members' name and their places of dwelling. He knows even our love for God Almighty, his son Jesus, and his church. And these are all reasons why Satan desires to destroy your life by sending flying arrows, attacks of spiritual arrows from the kingdom of darkness. Well, let's look at these arrows and investigate the study under these three subheadings. First of all, I want to deal with the classification of flying arrows. There's the arrow of death, the first classification. The arrow of death is one sent to kill people before their time. You do know a whole lot of people have endured death before their allotted time here on earth. This arrow of death may not know the source or the reason behind it, but it got to a young boy in the Bible, 2 Kings, the 4th chapter. The Bible talks about a young boy who had no symptoms of any sickness or infirmities, but suddenly he died because a flying arrow attacked his head. Well, if we were in to put it in layman's term today, he had a headache. The Bible tells us that his father took him to his mother and set him on his mother's lap, where he soon died. Yes, this was an arrow of attack. And many people have been killed through arrows of death in this matter by one or another. Some people, while sleeping without any prior sickness, will not wake up due to perishing in their sleep. Again, another arrow of attack. So it behooves us to call on the name of Jesus every opportunity that we get. Amen. And ask the fire of the Holy Spirit to destroy any arrows that come against us. Followed by an arrow of death is then an arrow of affliction. When an arrow of affliction is sent to a target, it will result in various afflictions and oppressions, most of which will not respond to any physical mean of solving the problem, unless when they are appropriately diagnosed spiritually and tackled with fervent prayer. Yes, fervent prayer under the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Another classification of fine arrows could be arrows of confusion and divisions. This arrow can separate the best of friends, the best of family relationships. You do remember Paul and Barnabas, who were called to work together by the Holy Spirit. They were doing a mighty fine job, the work committed unto them, until the arrow of division came against them. Now the argument became so pierced that they could no longer work together and had to choose another companion between themselves. This type of arrow can also cause divisions in homes, in families, in marriages, between husband and wives that have been enjoying their lives together according to the plan of God, will suddenly begin to work against each other due to hatred and bitterness caused by this arrow of division. Not only in the arrow of division, but another classification of flying arrows are known as arrows of character and disorder. Now, this arrow is making people, makes people misbehave whenever there's no reason or cause where they should not have misbehaved. This arrow was shot against Judas. You remember Judas. He made a move of betraying his master for monetary gain. And under any normal circumstances, Judas would not have thought of doing this. However, but under the influence of this satanic arrow, he did it and forfeit the kingdom of God. Following the arrow of character disorder is an arrow of devour. This kind of arrow is sent to attack somebody's wealth or prosperities. When I think of Job, when I think of this era, Job, who was an upright man, who exuded evil. The Bible says that one day that God allowed Satan to test Job. This era entered into Job's life, and all that he had labored for over 7 years, were ruined in a short time. But I come to tell you that God was able to allow the enemy to touch his possessions, but not his life. And I'm thankful that God is still faithful today, that regardless of Satan's results and the desires to destroy God's people, he has to have a permissive will from God. Finally, as I close on today, there's an era of generational strongholds and court and curses. This kind of era is known for causing a cycle of evil within our nation. It can be a particular kind of sickness or disease that is common among God's people, such as a coronavirus. But thank God that the anointing from the Holy Spirit can override a generational stronghold of any disease, a plague in the nation. You too, amen, can experience this by calling on the name of Jesus where you are. Allow the Holy Spirit to protect you and your household from the flying arrows of death, from the flying arrows of affliction, confusion, division, disorder, and strong generational attacks. You are an overcomer today, saint, by the blood of Jesus Christ. Allow the Holy Spirit to work, amen, God's permissive will in your life. Yes, we're in a battle, but the battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. So ask the Holy Spirit to breathe on us today, to stay, amen, say to yourself, I am delivered. I am an overcomer. I am a survivor. And the Holy Spirit of God, he shall dwell in the secret place of the Most High under the shadow of the Almighty. Be blessed today in the Word of God. Wow.